Pieria, a place where the myth meets history, a region gifted by nature with unspeakable beauty, a perfect marriage of mountains and sea. Nature was extremely generous with Pieria, a place with ancient and rich history lost deep in decades. Located in the north of Greece, Pieria combines successfully agricultural and tourist growth. Apart from the coastal region, there is also the mountainous Pieria, that of Olympus and the Pieria Mountains, full of thick forests, fertile fields, traditional settlements, picturesque villages, great hospitality, historical monuments, folklore culture, and alternative tourism. Mountainous Pieria is a real terra incognita waiting for you to explore. Well, let's meet this unknown Pieria, which has so much to offer to its visitors. Our itinerary starts from a visit to Old Panteleimonas. In the shadow of Olympus, in an extremely unique landscape, in the horizon, there is the stone village of Old Panteleimonas. Built in the 14th century at the foot of Olympus, in a 500 meter altitude, this village was abandoned the last decades. Until 1978, when the settlement was characterized traditional, the dilapidated stone houses were restored according to traditional Macedonian architecture. Nowadays, Old Panteleimonas is a beautiful tourist region full of neatly stone-built cottages, picturesque pebble streets, age-long plane trees, traditional hostels, taverns, cafes, and craft workshops. In the village, there is an environmental school, which tries to educate its pupils about the environment. In the central pebble square of the village, there is an old stone church of St. Panteleimonas, always protecting its residents. Leaving the Old Panteleimona behind, we're heading for Old Poroi, another traditional settlement built in a 600 meters altitude. It consists of restored stone cottages of 17th and 18th century. Some of them function as traditional hostels, offering to the guests a combined atmosphere of old and modern facilities. Very near the village, there is an impressive forest, an excellent destination for someone to escape and walk the unique footpaths in a most unspoiled countryside. From the three traditional settlements of East Olympus, Old Skotina is built in a higher altitude, reaching the 750 meters. For this reason, it is gifted with a unique view over the sea. Old Skotina is an idyllic settlement full of stone houses, old stone churches, and squares with plenty of widespread running water. Flooding springs with crystal clear waters coming from the center of Olympus, making a wonderful picture of the surrounding landscape. Flooding water, endlessly running into the ground, reminds us of the steady flow of time and the struggle of humans to freeze the time, even for a while, just to leave their footprints in eternity. Even with a few local residents, Old Skotina offers great hospitality, welcoming every year thousands of visitors enjoying the fresh air and the incredible view, not forgetting to visit the Old Stone Church of Assumption Day, a tri-basic post-Byzantine wooden royal church beaming modestly its foregone glory. Old Leptokaria is also an abandoned settlement which has been under reconstruction during the past few years, and so it has livened up again. As old as the hills, not far away from the seashore. In this settlement lie the ruins of St. Nicolaus Church and the Byzantine Church of Holy Trinity. Ancient Levithra lies in the perennial plain forest of unique beauty, characterized as a natural monument. It is the homeland of mythical Orfea, who fascinated all the creatures on earth by playing his lyre. In Pieria, some occupations remain intolerable through time. The marble carver continues the tradition through centuries, carving ornamental pieces with ancient patterns. The sound of chisel, same through decades, leaves its marks on the ancient marbles of the Greek land. Continuing our itinerary, we passed Litochoro, the main entrance for climbing the gods' mountain Olympus. The whole South Pieria is under the shadow of magisterial Mount Olympus. Olympus is not just the highest mountain in Greece, it was also the residence of gods for ancient Greeks. Olympus as a landscape is breathtaking. It creates sensations of freedom and mysticism and alerts the imagination. Today, Olympus is an extraordinary monument of nature and one of the greatest national forests of our country. Climbing Olympus is additionally an initiation to the majesty of nature. Olympus is traversed by plenty of paths and is a true paradise for hikers and mountaineers. There are many ambitious mountaineers who visit Olympus during summer and wish to conquer its peak, Mitikas, at 2,918 meter altitude. Mount Olympus is full of crystal water springs, fountain slushes. This is why it's so green and keeps a cool microclimate even in days of summer heat. The Hiking Marathon of Olympus is an annual sports event that it has been held successfully since 1986. It's an adventurous, long-lived event of our country, aiming to promote mountain sports. One of the most marvelous landscapes of Olympus is the valley of the river Enipeia, where there is an abandoned monastery of Saint Dionysius. In an 1850 meter altitude, in a mystical and idyllic location, stand gracefully the ruins of one of the most magnificent monasteries in Greece. The monastery was built in the early 16th century by Saint Dionysius. More than 100 monks used to liven up the monastery before it was burned for the first time in 750, the second in 1828, the third in 1878, but the total destruction of the monastery came in 1943. Since then, the monastery remains uninhabited and abandoned, apart from the existence of a monk guard. Built Built on the foothill of Mount Olympus, ancient Dion was one of the oldest cities of Macedonia. Its existence dates back to the 6th century BC, while it advanced as a big, vivid and sacred city till the 4th century AD. Palmers from all over Greece and the powerful Greek kingdoms of the east used to visit Dion to donate money to its citizens, pray and promise offerings to its temples. The citizens were having a prosperous life, as we can tell from the wealthy villas, such as the famous Villa of Dionysus, with the well-preserved mosaics located in the eastern part of the city. Excavations at Dion began in 1928, but went on intensively by the professor Dimitrios Pandermalis during 1973 till 1988, when they proved that Dion was the sacred city of ancient Macedonians. Today, while hearing the sound of the frogs singing, a visitor can stroll around among the floating ancient temples under the shadow of high trees. One can enjoy a travel back in time. Apart from the significant archaeological site, there is also the traditional country-style hostel in Dion village, equipped with a workshop full of traditionally made arts. There are some women in the village who know very well the art of looming, which tends to disappear in Greece. They weave patiently textile works which have their personal taste. They also know how to produce drinks and charms in a traditional way. This is why their products are as tasty and pure as homemade tastes, something which is very rare nowadays. In Dion, there is a workshop making mosaic in a traditional way, which is run faithfully by a local family. It is about a foregone art which tends to extinct, and for this reason, the municipality supports the tutorial of this art of mosaic through the introduction of a specific workshop. In Dion, the ancient Macedonian city, lying on the foot of Olympus, the International Festival of Olympus takes place every year, with theatrical events, concerts, dancing, conferences, and archaeological exhibitions. Another important factor of agricultural economy of Pieria country is the kiwi growing, which were imported in the region during the 1980s. Thanks to the frequent rainfalls and high mountains, Pieria country has got plenty of natural springs of water flowing all year round. A visitor can stop at one of those founts, which are usually on the sides of the roads, and quench his thirst with cooling water. Among the venturous hills of Highland Pieria, herds of sheep browse fresh grass. Cattle breeding is very important to the inhabitants of the isolated villages in this highland. The Monastery of Holy Trinity is a picturesque monument which dates back to 14th century and is built on rocky ground on a bluff of Mount Olympus. It attracts plenty of visitors who come to admire the wonderful view of the magisterial peaks of Mount Olympus. 4 kilometers away from the village Frondou, at the end of the provincial road at the foothill of Mount Olympus, there are 175 stairs leading down to a gorge where there is the church of Agia Kori. As we walk through the municipality of Petra, the view is superb. The scenery is magnificent and the view of Mount Olympus outstanding. Petra has always been a traverse. The Straits of Petra are a historical site of great importance to the locals and an attraction for tourists. Between Mount Olympus and Pieria Mountains, on a 900 meters altitude, lies one of the oldest and most beautiful villages of Pieria country, Agios Dimitrios. It is situated in a valley of great archaeological significance thanks to the Mycenaean tombs excavated in the area. The villages of Agios Dimitrios are traditional people. Someone can tell by their everyday life and customs, or even by the way they built the houses. Formerly, the residents were mostly ranchers, farmers, or woodcutters. In the recent years, the state has funded them through a program called LIDA to construct traditional hostels, taverns, and restaurants according to Macedonian architecture, where a visitor can rest and have delicious meals. Wild boar and deer, reared in local farms, zestfully cooked, are some of the dainties which are served, preferably with domestic red wine. The women of Agios Dimitrios, especially the elder ones, are very familiar with traditional cooking and gastronomic secrets. They bake their own homemade bread, make pies of nettle, and collect tea from the mountain and fruit to make jam or preserves. They're even organized in local women's institutes and sell the products to visitors. We leave Agios Dimitrios behind and go north to Anio Milia, a small traditional and historical settlement. Its few residents are well-known wild boar breeders. Anio Milia is a tourist attraction because of the remains of a tower, the house of an influential family called Lazei. Their members were warriors who resisted slavery and fought in Mount Olympus. Anio Milia was also a stoppage for another important Umwelt personality, Cosmas Etolos. In memory of his life and teaching in the village, in 1763, he carved an iron cross on a pine next to a church which can be seen till today. Kato Milia is another village built on a lee slope of Pieria Mountains. Its name Milia means apple tree in Greek and is credited to the apple trees that are naturally grown in the territory. There is a cultural and educational association in the village of Kato Milia called Lazei, founded in 1964. Through the last decades, the Lazei Association has developed a significant cultural activity, and among its tasks is to write down, maintain, and promote the musical and dancing tradition of Milia. Lazei has gathered an important folklore collection that impresses the visitors. Another village called Rahi Pierias also produces delicious crunchy cherries, which constitutes a significant part in the local economy. Every May, the cherry-bearing fields turn red. Sierra of Pieria is blessed by nature, enriched with several species of vegetation, full of crystal water springs, idyllic terraces, and easily accessible footpaths. It has been a tourist attraction in recent years. The main destination for the majority of the visitors is Ela Tohori, a village situated in a 1,000-meter altitude of Mount Olympus. The village is close to the well-organized skiing establishments, which welcomes tens of thousands of sportsmen from all over Greece during the winter season. From the skiing facilities, Elatohori offers complete hospitality services for those who want to combine winter holidays with alternative treatment. The residents have given archaic names to the mountain resorts, traditional hostels and rental rooms. Nevertheless, Elatohori remains a mountainous village that combines the old with the new. The villages have maintained their special customs and traditional characteristics. Local traditional attire and appliances are exhibited at the Folklore Museum of Elatohori. The locals are most proud of their history, legends and customs. A legendary figure of the area is Thanasis, known as the Captain. He is famous for his capacity to create music by blowing leaves. His melodies alert people's appetite to dance. The surroundings in Pydna villages are colourful hills with forests of oaks, flowered valleys and fields. Grazing at the sides of the roads, herds of sheep and goats give life to the vivid scenery. Svendami is the main village of Pydna territory, with very energetic residents organized into associations. For the first time, a mountain bike race with 118 participants from all over Greece took place in Svendami in April 2007. Since then, this considerably important event, known as Svendami Mountain Bike Race, is held every year in April and is organized by the athletic association Anagenisi Svendamis. This successful race has already made a lot of funds from the whole of the country. Exohi is a beautiful settlement of traditional small cottages in a 200-meter altitude. Like most of the villages in the territory, the inhabitants grow cereals and tobacco. A small artificial lake, which was shaped by a dam built by locals for irrigation purposes, adds to the beauty of the site. Most of the residents come from Pontus and try hard to preserve the customs. They organize feasts such as Parharia that take place in Exohi every year. As we are heading to the north of Pieria country, there are more surprises to come. Kolindros is lying in front of us, a very beautiful town at the foot of the mountains with 4,000 inhabitants located in the north part of the country. Kolindros has a rich history, but also a very significant Macedonian architecture. Densely infrastructured, with picturesque narrow streets, it gives a sense of warmth and reflections of old times, since the history of Kolindros is lost in the infinity of time. There are many elements about the city's history in the Macedonian Museum of Kolindros, where scripts, writings, books, photos, craftworks, local costumes, etc. are exhibited. Not far away from Kolindros, at Kapsalos location, there is a powerful athletic center with modern and high standard facilities which accommodate teams and demanding athletic missions. The region itself is an oasis of relaxation, which hosts a lot of athletic and cultural events, especially during summertime. Kolindros is famous for its delicious cherries, and every May the crunchy cherries harvesting from the regional crops is a festival for the villagers. Among twinkling beams of light, through the green leaves of the trees, we can see in front of us Castagna. Castagna, which is almost drawn into the green scenery, is surrounded by an oak forest. Entering the village, where the old church of St. Nicholas is located, there is a perennial oak wood, while an age-long plane tree is nominated as a monument to nature. Paliambelo is a flat village, 4 kilometers north of Kolindros. Getting his inspiration from the distant past, the clay man of the village prepares the clay in the traditional way, making clay pots using an old oven not very different from the ones they used during ancient times. There is a proud feeling for the continuation for the art of clay, which doesn't leave visitors untouched. North of Kolindros, on a low greenish row of hills, there is another village called Livadi. Its historical presence is known since Turkish domination, when the settlement was bought by wealthy Greeks who lived near the River Danube countries. Later the settlement and the surrounding area came to the occupation of St. Gregorius Monastery called Metochi. This Metochi, which has been raised until today, has been restored and distinguished as an influential monument around the region. Pieria is one of a few regions which combines harmonically the mountain with the sea, the nature with the picturesque villages, the civilization with entertainment, and finally, history with modern life. Especially North Pieria, which is a real terra incognita, has a lot of beautiful and pleasant surprises to offer to its visitors. Our tour in the magnificent mountainscape Pieria has left us with the most wonderful impressions, and we hope it was the same for you.